Tales, The Wizard of Oz. Dorothy lives with her Aunt Em and Uncle Henry on a farm in the beautiful countryside. There is always something to do, so Dorothy helps with the chores. Today, Aunt Em has asked her to fill up all these cartons with eggs ready to take to market. Dorothy wishes she had someone to help her. Then it wouldn't be quite so lonely and it wouldn't take quite so long. Suddenly, a big black storm cloud rolls in. There's a flash of lightning and a rumble of thunder. Then all the lights go off in the farmhouse. Dorothy feels quite scared. But in the darkness, a warm golden light shines brightly from a little mouse hole in the skirting board. Dorothy watches as something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger until there's just enough room to crawl through to the other side. Dorothy crawls through the mouse hole and into a magical forest. She is so excited, she sets off at once to explore. Dorothy just loves to smell the flowers, but they always tickle her nose. She does a great big sneeze just as a witch flies past on her broomstick. It gives her such a fright, she flies straight into a tree. She disappears with a bang and a puff of smoke. Dorothy feels just awful. What has she done? A cowardly lion, Tin Man, and Scarecrow come out from their hiding place. They are very happy indeed. "The whole forest thanks you," says the Tin Man. "You have saved us from the Wicked Witch of the East." The Scarecrow tells Dorothy if she follows the yellow brick road all the way to the Emerald City, the Wizard of Oz is sure to grant her one wish as her reward. But oh dear, Dorothy can't walk all that way without any shoes on her feet. So the Scarecrow gives her the Wicked Witch's silver shoes. She just loves her new shoes. Now she can go to the Emerald City. But she can't think of anything to wish for. "What would you wish for?" she asks her new friends. The Cowardly Lion would wish for courage. The Tin Man would wish for a heart. And the Scarecrow would wish for a brain. Dorothy still doesn't know what to wish for. But she would very much like the Lion, Tin Man and Scarecrow to come with her to the Emerald City. "Perhaps the Wizard of Oz could grant your wishes too," she says. "Wouldn't that be wonderful?" So they set off on their adventure, following the yellow brick road, round and round the forest. The Emerald City is very far away. Dorothy is so glad she has her friends to keep her spirits up along the way. They have walked such a long way and they are starting to feel very tired indeed. But they must keep going. At long last, they arrive at the Emerald City. But it's not very green at all. The Wizard of Oz quickly pulls on a very big lever. All of a sudden, everything becomes the most peculiar shade of green.
"You've come at a bad time," says the wizard. I'm very busy.
But we defeated the Wicked Witch of the East, says Dorothy. We would like you to grant our wishes, please.
Of course, says the wizard. But first, you must defeat the Wicked Witch of the West.
The Cowardly Lion and Tin Man tremble with fear.
She is even more horrible than the Wicked Witch of the East, says the Scarecrow.
I'll do it, says Dorothy, feeling very brave.
And we'll help you,
says her friends. Gloomy grey storm clouds hang over the castle, but Dorothy bravely leads the way. The Scarecrow spots a trapdoor. He pulls Dorothy away just in time. Underneath is a big, black, bottomless pit. The Scarecrow quickly and cleverly ties a piece of straw tightly round the trapdoor. It holds fast. Now it is safe to go into the castle. The Wicked Witch of the West stirs a potion in her big, black, bubbling cauldron. The Cowardly Lion bravely roars. The witch has such a fright. She doesn't like surprises, not even one bit. So she points her finger and casts a spell. The Tin Man tries to protect his friend. The magic spell bounces off his tin chest. Dorothy is so angry, she throws a bucket of water over the witch. With a bang and a puff of smoke, the Wicked Witch of the West is no more. The Wizard of Oz is so happy they have defeated the Wicked Witch of the West. Now he must grant their wishes as he promised. The lion wishes for courage.
Your wish is granted, says the wizard.
He hands the lion a potion of courage. The lion drinks it all up.
It tastes good,
he says. The Tin Man wishes for a heart.
Your wish is granted,
says the wizard. He puts a new heart safely inside the Tin Man's empty chest. He feels his heartbeat for the very first time. The Scarecrow wishes for a brain.
Your wish is granted,
says the wizard. He empties a jar of brand new brains into the Scarecrow's head. Now he feels very clever indeed. Dorothy is quite worn out after her big adventure. The mouse hole seems so very far away. She knows just what to wish for.
I wish to be back at the mouse hole so I can go home to the farm, she says.
Your wish is granted,
says the wizard. He sprinkles magic dust onto Dorothy's silver shoes. Now they will take her anywhere she wants to go. All she has to do is click her heels 3 times. Dorothy thanks her new friends for all their help before waving goodbye. She clicks her heels 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Dorothy's wish has been granted. She is back at the little mouse hole. She takes one last look at the yellow brick road before crawling through to the other side. Dorothy is glad to be home, but she misses her new friends terribly. And she still has all her chores to do. If only she had someone to help. But who's that at the door? Dorothy's cousins have come to visit. They help Dorothy put the eggs into the cartons one by one. And in no time at all, they are all done. Now they can go outside to play. Dorothy enjoyed her adventure, but she thinks there really is no place like home. Cartoonito Tales, Pinocchio. Geppetto is a very lonely little boy. He doesn't have any brothers or sisters, and he lives far away from all his friends. When he's not at school, he has to make do with his own company. Geppetto is very good at carving things from wood. He has made little pots and wooden tops. And look, a toy car. But now the time has come to make himself a friend. At last I'll have someone to play with, thinks Geppetto. So he works and works, polishing and smoothing, until he has made a little boy out of wood. I'll call him Pinocchio, he says. But even though Geppetto loves Pinocchio very much, he still feels lonely. Soon it is time to go to bed. Geppetto tucks Pinocchio in under a blanket of soft, warm felt. Good night, Pinocchio, he says. Geppetto pulls up the covers. He closes his eyes and falls fast asleep. That night, Geppetto dreams a very strange dream. He looks for Pinocchio, but he's not on the sofa, and the little felt blanket has fallen to the floor. Geppetto hears the clip-clop of little wooden feet. It's Pinocchio. He has come to life. But where is he going? He clip-clops across the room and into the little mouse hole. Geppetto wakes up. What a strange and wonderful dream! If only it were true! Geppetto pushes off the covers and leaps out of bed. He has to find Pinocchio! Poor Geppetto! Pinocchio really is missing! Perhaps he's still in the mouse hole. Geppetto reaches inside to find him. And as he does, something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger, until there is just enough room to climb inside. Am I still dreaming? Geppetto wonders as he crawls through the little arch. On the other side of the little mouse hole, there is a magical forest. Geppetto is just in time to see the blue fairy cast a magic spell. But she is very shy and runs off into the forest before Geppetto can say hello. But he's not alone for long. Who's this little boy?
I'm Pinocchio, he says.
Geppetto is so excited. A real boy to play with.
I'm Geppetto. Would you like to explore the forest with me? He asks. Pinocchio doesn't know what a forest is, but Geppetto seems like a nice boy, so he agrees. He doesn't tell Geppetto, but he doesn't know anything about the world at all. Geppetto is very curious to learn all about Pinocchio. Where do you live? He asks. But Pinocchio doesn't know, so he tells a lie.
My mother is a queen and my father is a king. We live in a big castle, he says.
Then the end of his nose begins to tingle. It begins to sparkle. And all of a sudden, it grows.
Perhaps this happens to all little boys,
he thinks. Geppetto doesn't even notice. He's far too busy exploring the forest.
Wait for me!
Pinocchio shouts as he chases after him. Geppetto and Pinocchio are excellent explorers. They have found a clear blue pond. At the water's edge, Geppetto has an idea. Let's see if we can skim these stones, he says. Geppetto is very good at skimming stones. They bounce, bounce, bounce across the water. But Pinocchio doesn't know how to skim stones. He throws one and it lands with a big splash in the reeds. Don't worry, says Geppetto. I'll get some more stones. A little green cricket lives in the reeds. He's very cross.
Did you throw the stone that landed in my home?
The cricket asks Pinocchio. Pinocchio doesn't want to get into trouble, so he tells a lie.
No, it wasn't me,
he says. Then the end of his nose begins to tingle. It begins to sparkle, and all of a sudden, it grows.
I know you're telling lies because your nose is growing, says the cricket.
Oh, no, sir, I'm telling the truth, says Pinocchio.
And with that, his nose tingles and sparkles and grows even more.
Until you learn to tell the truth, your nose will keep on growing,
says the cricket as he marches back into the reeds. Poor Pinocchio doesn't want his nose to grow any longer. He makes a promise there and then never to lie again. Geppetto and Pinocchio have lots of fun in the forest, climbing the trees together. But Geppetto starts to feel sad. I wish I didn't live so far away from all my friends. Then I could have someone to play with every day, he sighs. Pinocchio feels very upset. His new friend is so lonely. He wants to make him feel better, so he tells a lie.
I can pick up your house and carry it all the way into town, says Pinocchio. Then you'll have lots of boys and girls to play with.
It's such an enormous lie. The end of his nose begins to tingle. It begins to sparkle. And all of a sudden, it grows. It seems like it will never stop. Geppetto can't help but stare.
What's happening to your nose?
He asks.
Nothing,
says Pinocchio, shaking his head. But he's told another lie. So his nose tingles and sparkles and grows even more. It hurts very much when it bumps into a tree. Poor Pinocchio feels very sad. His nose is enormous. He just wants to be left alone. Pinocchio sits at the water's edge. He looks at his reflection.
His nose is extraordinarily long. It doesn't take the cricket very long to work out Pinocchio has been telling lots of lies.
You are a silly boy, says the cricket, but perhaps you deserve one more chance.
So the cricket rubs his wings together to call for the blue fairy. She appears at his side.
Oh, Pinocchio, have you been telling lies?
She asks. Pinocchio nods. He feels very silly indeed.
If you promise to always tell the truth, I will cast a spell to shrink your nose,
says the blue fairy. Pinocchio promises to always tell the truth. The blue fairy waves her magic wand and Pinocchio's nose shrinks and shrinks until it's back to normal again. Pinocchio is so happy, he thanks the blue fairy for her kindness.
Mr. Cricket, I'm so sorry for telling lies, he says.
The cricket smiles.
I'm sure it won't happen again, he says.
Poor Geppetto has been looking all over the forest for Pinocchio.
Are you okay?
He asks.
I've never been better,
says Pinocchio. They play hide and seek all afternoon until it's time for Geppetto to go home. Geppetto doesn't want to leave his new friends, but it's getting late. He waves goodbye before climbing through the mouse hole. Geppetto is glad to be home, but he still feels very sad about missing his wooden Pinocchio. There's a knock at the door. Who could it be? It's a little boy the same age as Geppetto.
Hello,
says the little boy.
I'm your new next door neighbour. Would you like to play with me?
Geppetto is so happy. Now he has someone to play with every day.
You've been watching the Cartoonito YouTube channel. For more fun stuff like this, click the subscribe button.